In this series, this is the most important video. This side, Arshdeep Singh, and welcome to Antoine YouTube channel. As you can see on the screen, I have a Node AI agent. With this node, we can do all the things which we can think of wherever AI is required in our workflow, be it text extraction, be it summarization, be it data insight generation, be it analysis or a chat system altogether. Or let's just say I want a draft email to be sent, specially tailored for whatever email I have received, right? So all those areas where AI can come into picture, this node is the way to go. In this video, I'll keep it very concise. I'm not gonna make it very difficult for you to understand. So in this video, it'll be a little crisp. Not every aspect of this node will be covered here, but don't you worry. The next video is a full-fledged video coming up with a complete workflow with a real-life example. And in that video, we'll be covering what amazing things can be done with N8N and especially with AI agent node, right? So let's just dive in and understand what this node is all about. All right, so this is the workflow which we're going to create, and I'm going to show you what this node is capable of doing, right? Let me just create this once again for you guys. I think we're clear with these two nodes. I can simply copy these two nodes here. I think we are clear with this. So let me just paste. Then obviously we can only have one trigger node. We already discussed that in one of our videos where I covered about trigger nodes, right? Okay, so now what exactly I want to achieve here? Let me just zoom in a little bit. So I have this Google Sheet account, right, connected with my N8N, and I want to generate some insights. So some business insights has to be generated based on a data sheet I'm having with me. That insight generation would be done with the help of AI. So how to do that, right? It's a very simple example, guys. I have a sheet, I can show you that. So this is the sheet I'm talking about. So this is a data. I took this sheet from Kaggle community, which is a very famous community for data scientists and data analysts. It's kind of a financial data, right? It's like a sample financial data. So what we have to do now is that we have to connect that data in our N8N with the help of Google Sheets node. I'm not going to repeat again and again all these nodes because I have covered these nodes in previous videos. If you are new to this series, I suggest you watch the previous videos. Very short, very simple, very crisp. All right, so let's just go ahead. So first of all, there is this data, right, which is present in a format. So if I simply test this step, what I want to show you guys is this is the data which I'm getting, right? If I show you this in table format, so that's how I'm getting this data, all that data in table format. In JSON, if you want to see, this is the format. We have fetched the data, point one done. But now, if I want to feed this to my AI, there should be a way, right? So to do that, I have to work on this data. I have to transform this data. So for that, I will use another node because this is in a JSON format, which I would say if we look, I'm not sure how much lines of JSON data this is. You can simply multiply 704 with these many number of lines. So if one object contains of 20 lines, then 20 into 704 items. So that's the total number of lines of JSON data this is, right? Instead of feeding all this text directly to my AI, rather just go with a different approach, right? We can convert that into a file. We can like contain this in a file because Google Sheets doesn't allow us to directly fetch a file. It only allows us to fetch data out of a file, right? Ultimately, what I wanted to do was I wanted to feed this sheet in itself, this file in itself, in this raw format to my AI agent, but that's not possible directly, right? Now, I guess we are sorted with what exactly I want to do here, right? All right, so for that, we have to simply use one node, which is convert to file. This is part of data transformation, which I covered in the previous video. You can watch that to understand it a little better. So in what format I want to convert this, whatever data that is. So I have this big chunk of JSON, which I want to convert to a single file, right? So I want it to be in CSV format because ultimately that is what we have in reality, right? The raw form is CSV only, right? So how to do this? Very simple. We simply have to set the operation. We can have some name here to our output file, right? So let's just keep it the way it is and let's just test this step. Now what this step does is, I hope, now this is the first time we are looking at some data which can be downloaded. This is a downloadable file. If I download this file and I open it here, all right, so this is the downloadable file and this is the same exact same data, right? But this time in a file format. Previously it was in JSON format, now this is in a file format. Now I'm gonna attach my AI agent. So for that, I have to simply use this thing. In here we have AI agent, right? Once that is done, there are a few steps which has to be followed. One thing is source for prompt, right? That is one thing. So that has to be defined below. It's not a chat. We are providing some kind of data, right? Simply copy this and paste it here. As simple as that. So this is what I have to do here. this is not the time to test this step. There are a few other things as well which has to be taken care of. So AI agent in itself a little complex component altogether. So we need to have few things in place to make sure this AI agent is working. For that, we need to have one chat model connected here. So there is a list of chat models. All of them, I guess you are aware of them, Anthropic, Azure, and then there is this, obviously, our favorite OpenAI's chat model. So one of these chat model has to be integrated here. Initially, N8N on a free account provides you with a sample credentials, and you can use that for that 14-day free trial. This is a paid version. So I have one OpenAI's a paid version, but if you don't have it, you can simply go for this N8N free OpenAI API credits, right? So with the help of this, I mean there are certain constraints to it, but I'm sure the queries will be sorted. I'm gonna stick to my own OpenAI's chat model account, and then we can select some model, right? So let's just go with chat 4 latest, right? And then there are a few other things which you can set, but let's just keep it very simple this time. This has been done. Now again, we're gonna go back here, and there is few things which I want my model to be specific with, right? So for that, we have to do one thing. We have to go into options. Now, this time I'm talking about the AI agent. I'm not talking about the model which we have connected here. System message. This is what I want to provide here. So let's just give it something like, you have to extract 10 business insights in bullet points from the given file in simple text format, right? And then I have also provided a note. You can go through this prompt. You can take a screenshot or something. You can copy paste this if you are working with me right now. Or else if you want to just make sure that, some different kind of prompting, some different kind of operation you want to perform. Let's just say you want a resume here, right? So you can simply have a resume, just upload your resume on a drive, and then you can connect that Google Drive's account with your N8N. After that, you can use that convert to file to some simple text or something like that, with the help of which you can have that file as an input for convert to file, and then inside convert to file. So let me just show that to you as well. Instead of convert to this, you can have text here, right? Yes, text file. So I'm just giving you some examples. Now, if you don't want to go with this example, you can have some different thing in your mind and you can play around, right? So this file name, if you're providing the file, has to be same here, right? And then with that in same context only, as you can see, the system message is also framed in a manner where it's easier for your agent to understand exactly what has to be done, right? So, okay, this is done. Now let's just test this step, right? Okay, it will take some time, right? And this is done. So as you can see, I can see an output here, which is not that much readable for you guys. So let's just go into logs, and then you can see. So this is the input which was given, and then this is the output. With input, there is also this data which was provided. So that has been sent directly as a file to your ChatGPT's model, chat model, and then this is the output, right? So it successfully generated 10 business insights from your financial data. See how simple that was, right? So you can have like different kind of things in your mind which you can use. Let's just say I have this model, let's just say I have this insights with me. I can then send this insight to some kind of sheet with the current timestamp, current date, making sure that, okay, for this day, these were the 10 business insights. And then let's just say that sheet which we have provided. So this financial data updates after every 5 days, right? So again, we can use a schedule trigger, which we covered in the first video. You're getting the gist of it, right? How we can have different kind of examples and we can create some sensible real life workflows, right? But this is all about automation using N8N, and obviously with the simple magic of AI, right? So I hope we are clear with how this thing works. There are a few other factors as well. You can attach some memory. So let's just say I want to create some kind of chat. In fact, something like this I have already done. You can see on the I button here or here somewhere, the Telegram bot, which analyzes your resume and provides you with some areas of improvement and some ratings where you can figure out that, okay, fine, so these are the areas of improvement which I can make sure I implement on my resume based on whatever job title is provided. All that is happening inside a chat. That is also inside Telegram. So all those things is possible. I have already covered a video on that. You can click on the I button. You can check that, right? So now for a chat to take place, that has to be stored somewhere. So for that, you use simple memory or some kind of other database. I mean, I'm going a little technical here for people, those who are not coming from development background. I mean, for them, it is a little complex, but whatever. Let's just keep it simple this time. So the next video, as I told you, is will be a full-fledged video where we are covering almost all the aspects of a workflow, right? One part of AI agent is handling the chat, right? The second part is handling the memory. And then the third part, tools is something which is a little complex, but I'm gonna try my best to make it very simple for you guys. Let's just say we have different set of conditions, which like there are four conditions. Out of them, any one or two may execute based on whatever input was provided. And so in those scenarios, we usually go with tools. Now, let's just say one tool is all about fetching the latest weather forecast for a particular place which was provided in the input, right? That is one scenario. Let's just say another scenario is that we want to fetch the latest news. So that has to come from some kind of API which provides you with the latest news and bullet points, and then you know that is one operation which can be performed and given as the output, right? Or maybe the third thing is about just hitting some kind of API. I just want to extract some image data. For that I have some HTTP API endpoint with me of a third party service, let's just say. So I can attach that inside my tool and I can create a prompt. That prompt is something which has to be given here inside the system. So this is the system message where you create, you lay out your, you know, the workflow of for your agent. That okay, fine, this is a simple thing which has to be done. Let's just say this is the type of input I'm getting, or this is the query which I'm getting. So you have to make sure that some kind of tool is used for that, right? That's the area where tools are used. I'm sure that we are sorted, theoretically at least, with what AI agent is. And you also saw a little gist of what things can be done with the help of AI agent. This is the most important video, for the matter of fact, in this series, how these workflows are built. I mean, I'm not going to say that only one node is important. Obviously, each and every node is a building block of a successful workflow. But this is very important, guys. So I'll meet you in the next video. Until then, happy learning and keep sharing these videos. The next video will be the last video of this series, which will be a little longer. It may be maybe a 1 hour video or maybe more than that, but I'm gonna make sure that it is worth watching for you all. So have a nice day.